Today we're going to be taking some notes. These will be your last notes for the school year. Yay. But you can find these as usual underneath the classroom tab. If you click on them, you'll see you've got two attachments today. Our traditional notes here, but then at the end, I'm going to go over a graphic organizer, and you can find that here in this Google Doc. But again, you've got your red text boxes to fill in. So in order to fill those text boxes in, remember, you just need to click on the image, scroll down, select edit, and then you can click on the text boxes. And then don't forget to press save and close. With that being said, we're going to go ahead and get started. So wrapping up our interactions and falls with empires unit, we've spent a lot of time talking about the different innovations created by these major empires and civilizations that rose during Era 3. These notes will really focus on how they fell apart and some of those common characteristics that historians have recognized through studying them. And these similarities follow a pattern. So the rise of empires really included three things. Having inspirational leadership, we talked about several leaders like Caesar Augustus, Ashoka the Great, Emperor Xin, though Emperor Xin probably would not be considered an inspirational leader, but we spent some time talking about others. Centralization through innovations and organizations, we did spend a lot of time talking about government structure, as well as social structure, and many of the innovations that were created in these empires. The wheelbarrow, global currency, talked about math and astronomy, all of those wonderful things that came out of these empires that we still use today. And then expansion through conquest and trade networks. We've spent quite a bit of time talking about the Silk Road, so was looking at the idea of militarism, how that impacted the society and expansion of empires. All of this will lead empires to reach their peak, where we see cultural achievements in science, art, mathematics, religion, engineering, and architecture. And we've spent quite a bit of time talking about the spread of the major world religions, development of art, pottery, painting, sculpture, science, the birth of astronomy, architecture, the building of large pyramids and aqueducts and irrigation systems, coliseums, the Great Wall of China, the Taj Mahal, many others. But just like everything, with a rise comes a fall, and so there'll be also four similar features of the fall of empires. Starting with overextension and loss of control. It's difficult to maintain a large area, spread out as they were without the advances in transportation that we have today. It's going to make it difficult to satisfy all of your citizens and protect them from the nomadic groups. Corruption. This is when there are dishonest decisions being made by political leaders, and this can cause many issues throughout society. Natural disasters and warfare. We've seen in a lot of these empires, natural disasters like drought and famine can really impact them supporting their citizens. Obviously, warfare, both internal and external. Internal with their own people, external with nomadic groups, other empires. And finally, the failure of social and political institutions to address societal problems. Rome, we know they had large issues dealing with religion and the separation between the rich and the poor. That could just be one example of how the social and political institutions failed. And we'll go into these four aspects and a little bit more in the next few slides. But all in all, while both of these things are happening, we see population growth and increasing population density. Our world is growing like never before. And again, this is really the start of our global community, our interconnectedness, leading us into the future. So what exactly caused these empires to fall? Going in more detail with those four characteristics. Starting first with the Huns, these were nomadic pastoralists. If you remember that from a couple units ago, nomadic pastoralists are the ones that raise animals and travel from place to place with them, otherwise known as herders. They'll be from the steplands of Central Asia. These are the hill and mountain ranges in and around the Himalayas, specifically in the country that is now known as Mongolia. The development of the stirrup allowed them to fight from horseback very effectively, even shooting arrows accurately from the saddle. So remember, stirrups are the things that you put your feet into when you ride a horse. They were created in Asia while the Han Dynasty was in power. As they grew, they began to move south and west in search of better pasture lands. In this process, they clashed with Rome, Han China, and the Gupta of India, entering all of these territories. They will contribute to the fall of all of these empires I've mentioned before. The most fierce was Attila the Hun, who was the ruler of the Huns from 434 until his death in 453. And by the time of his death, he was greatly feared by the Romans. So remember, the Romans had one of the most powerful militaries in the world. However, Attila the Hun had them shaking in their boots. Political corruption and inequality. All of these empires were characterized by large gaps between the rich and the poor. There are also a lot of corruption, again, dishonest political leaders, and greed on the part of the ruling class. This will lead to rebellions and unrest and weaken central control. We read about some of the rebellions in Rome, specifically the slave rebellions. And these will have large scale impact on the empires and leading to a lot of dissension and distrust between members of the empire. Sense of borders. All three empires had vast borderlands that needed protection and guarding. Their borders grew too large for them to effectively patrol and control. The image below is a map of Rome. As you can see, it covers several modern-day countries, which would make it extremely difficult to manage. You would need to have a massive army to protect all of your borders, all of your people. And so this is also going to cause them to fall apart. Epidemics. As trade increased and spread ideas and goods across this vast region, it also helped diseases spread. Large numbers of people in all these empires died from these epidemics, likely weakening economic production and social stability. Unfortunately, we know this to be true when disease spreads. You have to make decisions as far as what you want to shut down and how much interaction you want to have between your people. And when people can't work, you can't make money for the empire. There are a lot of changes that need to be made. The biggest epidemic is going to be the Black Death. It will first emerge in Era 3, but as you can see, it will continue to cause issues throughout the 14th and 18th centuries. The arrows represent those trade routes as well as how the Black Death will spread. And one of the greatest contributors to that, as you can see, the red arrows say approaching from Asia. It's a going to come from the Huns as they continue to migrate and invade different empires. So just some quick facts for you. In the Middle Ages, it was known as the Black Death, and it killed 50 million people in Europe. Now we don't see it as much. It is easily spread, caused by bacteria that make their way into the feces on small animals. We discussed this in it when we watched our Mankind episode. So kind of all of these common features together, and this is again for your graphic organizer on the Google Doc attached to your notes for today. Again, kind of a review to wrap up. The Huns, this nomadic invading group that will impact three of the major empires that we've talked about. That's not to say that the Christians were not impacted by nomadic groups. They will be. They will be taken over by the Coptics, who will then face the Huns. Also see, again, inequality and corruption leading to unrest. Large borders that are difficult to protect and control. And then epidemics like death, which are difficult to control and manage. Cause the death of the Middle Ages. How did these factors affect each empire? For the Han, this is the lack of central government led to a long period of problems. The later empires emerged and took advantage of the intact culture and beliefs and the history of the Chinese bureaucracy and dynastic rule. Again, bureaucracy is when you appoint people to your government positions. So while the Han will end up falling apart, it's important to remember that they are the beginning of the country of China, and the first time we'll see it unified and representing the country that we know today. In Rome, again, government systems will completely disappear. Similar government systems will not reemerge until the United States is founded. Conflict and lack of any central control over the former empire becomes the norm. It will change hands many times through different smaller kingdoms, other large-scale empires, and the eventual foundation of the country of Italy. And finally, the Gupta. Their culture and social systems will stay intact, as we talked about. The caste system is still going to be in use today. And the local rulers will continue to play a key role. So instead of having a more centralized government, they'll have a more individual government, similar to the Greek system. Okay. Trade was interrupted at times, but it never completely stopped. The different areas were more fragmented, and people continued to exchange goods over large areas. Again, this time period is the foundation of our global economy. As political systems lost power and religion gained power, Christianity became very important in the former Roman Empire with the foundation of the Roman Catholic Church, the conversion of the Roman people to Christianity, and the foundation of the Byzantine Empire. The lack of central control in areas led to a time of increased local and regional conflicts and nomadic groups fighting for control. Then cultural and technological advances didn't completely stop, but they do slow down. So knowledge was even lost, or at least less commonly used and applied than before. As we exit Era 3, the world will enter a time period known as the Middle Ages or Dark Ages due to this slowdown in advances in culture and technology. At this point, we are done. Again, please do not forget to do your exit ticket. Feel free to rewatch or listen to any part of this video. And hope you have a great rest of your day.